Yes, good morning friends, how are you all? Fine? Yes, I am also fine by the grace of God. I hope the same from you. Okay, welcome back to online classes again. So today, we will do the new topic, revised revision, comparing quantities. So still now, we have seen many chapters in arithmetic, in geometry, in algebra. But here, it is a very different topic, which is related to business and as well as day-to-day life. Total mathematics is connected to daily day-to-day life, but this chapter we will see more daily in series. Okay? So comparing is what? First of all, you should know what is comparing. When you want to compare, the things must be of same kind. For example, a fan is there. A fan cannot be compared with the stool because fan's properties are different and stool's different properties are different. You can't compare a classroom with a bench. Classroom is nothing but it's a spacious where children can sit, we can do something like that. But bench is only for sitting purposes. So many examples like pen and paper. Pen means you can write. Paper means on that you can write something. Pen means we can write with the pen only. With paper we can't write, but we can write with the pen on the paper. That means what? Comparing. In mathematics, comparing is known as ratio. What is this? Ratio. When you want to find out ratio means they must be of same kind. That means what? For example, you are taking bench with wooden. No problem. Both benches are there, but here it made up of with iron and it made up of wood. Right or not? So there is no problem. We can compare like this. Okay, right. Now, small example I'll show. Rupees 5 is to 75 paisa. If you observe rupees 5 and 75 paisa, you may tell that sir, both are rupees only. No, it is rupees but it is paisa. It is bigger and it is small. I am not talking about the number. I am talking about the units. Okay now? Therefore, I will change like this. 500 paisa is to 75 paisa. Now you can find out the ratio. Are you understanding? Now 5 1 0 0 5 1 5 5 again 5 2 5 0 5 3. Now you can't do anything, therefore 20 is to 3. This is paisa only, not rupees. Like that only. For example, 2 kilometers is to 800 meters. These both are measurements under length only, but both are not same units. Therefore, what we are doing is, kilometers we are converting to meters and meters as well as it is. These two zeros gone. Yes, 4 5 4 2. That's all. 5 is to 2. Yes, still more examples you can take. 4 kg is to 900 grams. Then what happens? Kg can be converted to grams and 900. These two zeros, zeros to zero. Therefore, 40 is to 9. 5 is to 2. 20 is to 3. These are all nothing but ratios. So in this comparing quantities, this is the first concept that you should find out. You should know about the ratio. Okay, now? Right. This ratio also can be written in the form of fraction. Okay, na? It can be written in the form of fraction also. Then fraction means immediately we will get decimals, we will get percentage. Many things we get. How? Now, for example, 2:3 ratio, that can be written as 2/3. So now this is ratio, this is fraction. Now fraction should be converted to percentage. Do you know what is the meaning of percentage? Percentage means per 100. Percentage means per 100. Now for example, 4/5 is there. There are two methods are there, whichever method you want you can take. In the first method is multiply throughout by 100, because percentage means 100. 5 1s 5 2 0, 24 80%. This is one of the methods. Second method, 4/5 into dash. Here down I want 100. By what number is multiply? 20. Here also you should multiply with 20. So 80/100 is nothing but 80% only. Are you understanding? Therefore, two types of methods are there. Whichever method you want, you can yes or no. Right? Some more are there. We will find out them. We'll start with them. Yes. Speed of a cycle. 30 kilometers. Very simple. 15 kilometers and 30 kilometers. See here, kilometer is there. Therefore, directly we can do it. So 15:30. 15 1 15 2. That's 1:2. Next, 50 paisa to 5. 50 paisa is to rupees 5. Now see, 50 paisa as this is to 5 rupees means 500 paisa. So 0, 0 cancel, 5 1 5 1 5 10. Therefore 1:10. Next, 5 meters to 10 kilometers. 5 meters to 10 kilometers. Therefore, 5 meters to 10 kilometers means 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. Therefore, 10,000 meters. 5 1 5 2 0 0 0. 1:2,000. Okay, na? Yes. Convert the following into percentages. So very very simple. Convert them into percentages. I told percent is what? It's for 100. You should calculate per 100. Okay? No problem. We'll find out. 3/4. First question, 3/4. I told you 3/4 into 100. 4 1 4 2 8. 24 5. It is equal to 75%. Okay, na? Next, 2:3. 2:3 can be written as 2/3. So percentage means 2/3 into 100 is equal to 200/3. Then 3 6 8, 3 6 8, 0.6. That's all. This much only. We can't do more than this. However, how many times you want, you will get the same thing only. Okay? Now, word problem. We'll see word problem. How word problems?
Yeah.
Before going to that word problem, we should know some of the basic things. Okay? For example, we will take apple. How many percent will not like apple? Very, very simple. Percent means what? 100. 100 minus 90, how much? Yes. 10% will not like apple. Like that only? 75% are good at English. That means what? 25% are not good at English. Understood? If you add these two, you should get 100 only. So we should take like this. Okay, na? If 90% is not good, 10% is good. If 75% is good, then 25% is not good. If 20% is good, 80% is not good. If 60% are good means 40% are not good. Understood? So you should know this. Very simple. Okay? Yeah. Now you can see the problem. What problem? Very, very simple. Yes. 72% of 25 students are good at maths. Good means 28 of 25 are not good in maths. At maths. Oh, answer. How many you want to get calculated? 28 divided by percent is 100. Into 25 4 7. Therefore, 7 students are not good at maths. That's very simple. Okay, na? So, like this, it is a 3-month question or 2-month question, whatever may be the marks, but the concepts will be like this. This problem students will solve in one more way. How? First they will find out 72% of 25. Yes. You can write R. 72% of 100 into 25. 25 1 jar, 25 2, 25 4 jar, 4 1 jar, 4 8 jar. Therefore 18 are good at maths. Therefore 25 minus 18 equal to 7 are not good at maths. Like this. Okay, na? So you can do like this or you can do like this. Both ones are the same, but you will get the same marks. Understood? Yes. Yes, a football team won 10 matches out of the total number of matches they played. Is their winning percentage was 40? Winning percentage. Is 40, then losing will be 60%. Okay, na? Now very, very simple. Okay. Now, if they are winning by 40, then how many matches did they play in all? 110 matches. Okay. Let the total matches be X. Therefore, 40% of X is 10. Very simple. Now, 40 divided by 100 into X equal to 10. x equal to 10 into 100 divided by 40. 0, 0 cancel. 2, 2 ja, 2, 5 ja. 2, 1 ja, 2, 5. Therefore, how many matches? Total matches. How many matches? 25 matches. Okay? So very simple. You should understand this problem. Next, if Chirmeli had 600 left after spending 75% of money, spending 75% money, she left. Yes, how much money? ₹600. That means what? 75. 25% of x is equals to ₹600. Let the total money be x. Therefore, 25 divided by 100 into x equal to 600. X equal to 600 into 100 divided by 25. 25 1 ja, 25 4 ja. So 2400 is the total money. Okay? Yes, you should do like this. Yes, next problem. If 60% people in the city like cricket, yes, 60% like cricket, 30% like football, 10% like other games. If the total number of people are 50 lakh, total people, rupees 50 lakh, then we will find 60 by 100 into 5 lakh. 2 zeros, 2 zeros. Therefore, 3 lakh like cricket. Next, 30% means 30 by 100 into 5 lakh. So it is nothing but 0, 0, 1 lakh 50 thousand like football. Yes. Now remaining. What's the percentage? 10%. 10% means 10 by 100 into 5 lakh. 2 0, 2 0. Therefore, 50,000. Other games. If you do total 100%, you get 5 lakh. Right? 3 lakhs. 4,50,000 and 50,000. It will be 5 lakhs. Okay. Now very simple problems, right? Now this is the percentage. Now we will see increase of percentage, decrease of percentage. Okay. Very, very important. Increasing and decreasing. Some of the questions we will see. Yes. For example, year's salary is ₹12,000. If 10% hike given, then what about new salary? Very, very simple. Now we should find out like this. 10% of 12,000. So 10 divided by 100 into 12,000. Two zeros. Therefore, 1200. Therefore, new salary will be 12,000 plus 1200. Therefore, it is 13,200. Okay, 13,200. This is the new salary. Like this. Okay. One more example we'll take. So very simple. Now we should find out like this. 50 by 100 into 20,000. So 20, 20. 15 2 30. 20. ₹3,000 increased. Therefore, new salary is equals to 20 plus 3,000 is equals to 23,000. Sometimes, if you take a vegetable seller is there, his will be, because here one day he will get Sunday. Sunday means what happened? Everybody will free, everybody will come. So Sunday, for example, his sale was 15% or 20% more. But in the other days, the percentage is less. That means what? You can take it. Monday, for example, 20% less. Of ₹20,000. Less means what you have to use. Now 20% of 20 by 100 into 20,000. Two zeros. 2 is 4. 4,000 less. Less means 20,000 minus 4,000. It is nothing but equal to 16,000. This is the less percentage and this is the high percentage. This is the high increase in percentage and this is nothing but decrease percentage. Understood? Yes. Next one is discount. Okay. Next one is what? Discount. Do you know what is discount means? Yes. In many shops, if you go, there will be advertisement like this: 20% off means whatever money is there, on that 20% will be less. For example, you see one shirt, the market price MRP is ₹1,200. How much? 1200. He has written 20% half. 20% means we should find out. 20% that is 20 by 100 of 1200.
100 12 to 24 240 rupees less. Therefore, the money to be paid, the money to be paid is equals to 1200 minus 240. It is nothing but 960. How much? 960. Therefore, 1200 shirt, they will get 960 rupees. Okay, na? Like this only, so many problems. One more problem I explain. This is discount. Discount are of honor sale. You can pay 15% discount or 15% sale. Like this. Sale how much? 15%. Now, a person has taken goods like this, rupees 12,000. How much? 12,000. So 15% sale is means 15% we have to reduce. So very simple. Now 15 by 100 into 12,000. So 2 zeros, 2 zeros. 1800 rupees is nothing but deduction. Therefore, amount to be paid is equals to 12,000 minus 1800. It is nothing but equal to 10,200. Okay, right? Therefore, new amount is what? 10,200. Like this. Okay? Yes. Now, discount means what? It is the reduction of price. Discount means reduction of price. Next one is cost price, selling price, profit and loss. Very, very important. Profit, loss, selling price and profit. Yes, profit, loss and selling cost price. Here, important points. Cost price, selling price. These two prices are very, very important. For example, cost price is less than selling price, it is a profit. If selling price is greater than, if selling price is less than cost price, then it is a loss. And one more thing is, see, whether loss or profit will be depends upon the cost price. It will not depend upon the selling price. Okay, na? Therefore, profit or loss percentage is equal to, you can write profit or loss divided by cost price into 100. So these are the important formulas to be remembered. And profit is equals to selling price minus cost price. Loss is equals to cost price minus selling price. Okay, na? So like this you should find out one by one. Okay. Now we'll see one by one. Right? Yes. So one by one problem, if you see, you will understand. Now I think so you got an idea of cost price, selling price, profit, loss and their percentages. Why percentage, loss and yes, we have seen increasing or decreasing percentage or discount or profit or loss, all are under percentage only. They are not in any other figures. Okay, na?
Yes.
One problem we do is very simple. Yes. A frog is there. Its price is ₹220, and they have given 20% discount. A frog is there whose MRP, that is maximum retail price, is how much? ₹220, and they have given, the shopkeeper has given 20% discount. So how much we should pay? Very very simple. Now you can take like this, 20% of 220, or 20 divided by 100 into 220. 0000. Therefore, how many rupees is discount? 44 rupees. Therefore, new price is equals to 220 minus 44. How much it is? Rupees 176. Okay, na? Like this. One more question. ₹577.80, but they have given 15% of discount. Is what they have done. Very very simple. 15% of 577.80, or 15/100 into 577.80. Okay, na? So very very simple. You can find out like this. Now how 577.80 into 15. So 0, 15 8 120, 15 7 105, 170. Sorry. 15 0 0, 15 8 120, 12, 15 7 105, 105 plus 12, 117 11, 15 7 105 again, 105 means 126. 6, 12, 15 5 75 87. Okay, na? Yes. So if you convert this to round off figure like this, 580, then you will get correct answer. Okay, na? Yes. Now approximately is 580. 101 101. Now you can save 15 8 120, 15 5 75 87. Okay, na? Divided by, sorry, 0. Therefore, it is nothing but around 87 rupees less. Therefore, 580 minus 87, it is nothing but 493 rupees. Okay, na? Correct? No? Yes, sorry. 493 rupees. 580 minus 87, 3, again 93. Okay? Like this. Okay? Yes, take out this. Next one is, one more important is value added tax, PAT. So this value added tax should be added. The name itself tells that value added tax. We should add to the price. For example, Mr. A went to market and he purchased goods of 20,000. How much? 20,000. And always now if you see GST is there. Goods sales tax. Okay na? Goods are sales. Whatever goods if you want to sell, then you should pay some amount. That is nothing but tax. Now for example, 8% tax is there. If your bill is 20,000, you should pay 8% of this extra money. That is only GST. Okay na? That is only VAT, value added tax. How to percent? 8%. 8 divided by 100 into 20,000. 2 zeros, 2 zeros, 1. 8 to the 1600 rupees. Therefore, 1600 rupees you should pay more. That means what? 21,600 you have to pay this amount. If your bill is 20,000, you should pay 21,600. If it is sales tax, also same. Sales tax or VAT or GST, one and the same only. So this tax you should discount means subtraction. Profit and selling price is different. Percentage is different. And here value added tax or goods sales tax or service tax all are should be added on the total amount. Understood? Very very important. Okay. I hope you are understanding this session. Okay. So one or two problems you see, then you will see the other problems in next class. Right? Okay. Now one problem we discuss. Very very simple problem. A man got 10% increased salary. 10% increased salary. Now you see how to find out, how to tackle the problem. You see 10% high salary. The new salary is 1,54,000. The new salary is how much? 1,54,000. 10% high. We have to find out his original salary. Very very simple. So how original salary? For example, let the original salary be rupees X. Then what happened? Original salary plus how much increase? 10%. 10% on which? Yes, total amount will be equal to 1,54,000. Very simple. If you know the concept, then it is very easy. Right? Now X plus 10% means 10 by 100X is equals to 1,54,000. Now 0, 0 cancel. 10 will go here. 10X plus X is equals to 154 and one more 0. Therefore, 11X is equals to 50,40,000. Then X equal to 50,40,000 divided by 11. 11 1 ja, 11 1 ja, 11 4 ja. Therefore, his salary was how much? 1,40,000.